back again. Today we'll be discussing about a topic named as data analysis using Pandas. Pandas is a most popular Python library that is used for data analysis. It provides highly optimized performance with backend source code which is written in Python or C, completely written in Python or C. We can analyze the data using Pandas in two methods. One is series and the other is data frames. Series is nothing but a 1D array defined in Pandas that can be used to store any data type. Series can hold any data types like a scalar in the sense any integer value or a string, and also it can hold a dictionary, the data structure in Python, and also an n-dimensional array. So I'll show you using the code. First, let's create some data with the name as data variable list. Then we'll give you values to it like 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Series is an 1D data frame. Data frame is a multi-dimensional thing. So let's store it in here. First, we need to install Pandas library using the pip install command. Pip install pandas, then we'll be importing pandas, as pd. Yeah, just we are importing the pandas library as a shorter name known as pd. Then we'll create a new variable, something like s is equals to pd dot series of the given data. It also has index, right? So we'll define a index to it, right? We have 6 values, so we'll be defining 6 variables for it, like a comma b comma c comma d. All right, perfect. Then we'll create another s1 is equals to pd dot series of data with the index values. In the S, it only contains the data with the default index as 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Whereas in S1, we have, without using the default, we have given our own index. I'll show you by printing it. Print S, and then we'll print S1. This is the text to show that our pandas library is being installed, so don't worry about that. Here we can see the list elements like 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, the data, and the index which was generated by default as 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. In the S1, we have the value data as 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, and the indexes as A, B, C, D, E, F, as we have mentioned it here. Alright? Perfect. So, next we'll be converting a dictionary into a series, which is very simple. Like dictionary is equals to, let's define some key value pairs, like A has value 1 and B has value 2, C has value 3 and D has value 4. Take a variable name as s is equals to pd dot series of the dictionary name. Then we'll print sd. So we can see here a, b, c, d, 1, 2, 3, 4. We have converted a dictionary into a series, right? Next, we'll be converting an n-dimensional array into a series data type, like the data is equals to, we'll create an n-dimensional array like 1, 2, 3, comma, 4, 5, 6, comma, 7, 8, 9. Okay. Then we'll store it with snd variable name like pd dot, it's capital S, series of data. Then we'll be printing the snd. So we can see here 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9 are the data with the indexes which are generated by default 0, 1 and 2. Whereas in the dictionary, the indexes are taken as the key value, I mean key, and the data is taken as the value 1, 2, 3, 4. Right? Perfect. Next we will be discussing about the data frame. We have just talked about the series of use data analysis using pandas. Now we'll be talking about data frame. Data frame is a two-dimensional data structure of different pandas which consists of rows and columns, whereas series doesn't contain rows and columns. So what we'll do, let's take and here the data can be dictionaries or a 2D numpy n-dimensional array, or it can also be a series. We can convert one or more series into a data frame. I'll show you how. First, I'll show you dictionaries. Like dictionary 1 is equals to, I'll copy paste this one. And I'll also take another dictionary, like dictionary 2 is equals to E with value 5, F with value 6, G with value 7, H with value 8. Over. Then we'll be taking the data is equals to, like the first dictionary is, we'll mention it as first with the dict 1. That is our dictionary 1, and then the second with dict 2. Perfect. Guys, then problem expected. Sorry. Okay, the data must be in a curly braces, the flower brackets, not in a list comprehension type. Perfect. Then we'll be taking a df is equals to pd dot data frame of the data, and we'll be simply printing the df. That is our data frame. So here dictionary 1 contains the values a to d and here e to h. So here we are creating first as dict 1 and second as dict 2. That is, we are having two different columns with names first and second, and for this key value, that is A, we have 1 here and the second has none, because second doesn't have A variable, it starts from E. So E will be having a value of 5. As E is not defined in the dictionary 1, it has value as NaN. It indicates none. Okay. So we have converted dictionaries into a data frame. Now we'll be converting the series into a data frame. So we have already created few series here, right? Let's take this one. Or else we'll create a new series, no problem. This one is equals to pt dot series of, let's take a list like 1, 6, 5, 2, 3, 6. And we'll take S2 is equals to pd dot series of let's take some floating point decimals like 1.1, 2.3, 4.5 and 8.9. okay, it's perfect. Then we'll be taking another S3 is equals to pd dot series with the values as characters like a comma b comma c comma d, and the alphabets like e, perfect. Now the data will be taken as with the first column name as first, whose values will be S1, and the second column names as second, whose values will be S2, and the third column names will be third. You can give any names here which suits to your data. then we'll be simply first we need to convert into our data frame. So pd dot data frame of the data. Perfect. Now we'll be just printing the df. Perfect. Yes, yeah, so we can see here the first column name is first, second is second, and third is third, and we have the values here. As we didn't give any index values by default, it takes as 0, 1, 2, 3, 4. So the first values are 1, 5, 2, 3, 6. And the second, we have only given 4 values, not 5. So last one is taken as NN, none. And similarly, the characters as A, B, C, D, E. You can see it here. Alright, guys. So next we'll go to, we'll be converting a 2D NumPy n-dimensional array into a data frame. It's too similar like this. We'll copy paste it to save the time. This is the n-dimensional array we have done here. Yeah, here is an n-dimensional array. So let's keep this name as data1 and we'll take another variable name as data2. We'll change the values 7, 3, 4. This will be 4, 9, 1, and this will be like 1, 3, 2. Perfect. Now we'll create a variable name as data, where we'll be storing both these data with the column names. Data is equals to first, whose values will be data one, and then second. Sorry, it's second, whose values will be data two. Finally, we'll be creating a data frame of two-dimensional array, which is equals to pd dot data frame. Pd in the sense it's pandas. We'll just given a new name also known as pd to make our life easier of the data. Then we'll be simply printing the our data frame. Print df2d. Yeah, so you can see here first and second, as we have mentioned, the column names, and then the elements as 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, and the second data, second column has 7, 3, 4, 4, 9, 1, and 1, 3, 2. Perfect. So that's it, guys, for this session. Hope you have understood how to do data analysis using pandas via series and data frames. Thanks for listening, this guys. Stay safe.